Welcome to an introduction to Java programming language. The objectives for this session will be to know about the history of Java, to know about the evolution and purpose of Java, to know about the platforms of Java, to know who owns Java, to know what is JDK, what is JVM, and what is JRE, to know Java's magic, the bytecode, to know the features of Java. Well, to begin with the introduction, Java is a well-known programming language now. But earlier to this, Java was known to be an island in Indonesia. Java, Sumatra, and Borneo are the three islands that constitute Indonesia. It was also known as a coffee bean, which was grown in Indonesia. James Gosling is known as the father of Java. Here we can see a picture of James Gosling. Now, James Gosling, Mike Sheridan, and Patrick Norton in 1991 initiated a project called Green Project to develop a computer language to run on electronic devices. They worked at Sun Microsystems, which was an American company. The team of the three engineers was named Green Team. They developed a language and named it Green Talk. It was then named as Oak, which is the name of a type of tree, but it was already a trademark by Oak Technologies, so they had to find out some new name for the language they had developed. James Gosling was very fond of having coffee, and while having coffee near his office, chose the final name Java, and it was accepted because it was so unique. Java was introduced by Sun Microsystems in 1996. It has evolved from and is based on the concepts of C and C++. The very first Java compiler developed by Sun Microsystems was written in C. Now, let's come to the purpose of Java. When there were already languages like C and C++, what was the need for a new language? Well, Java was designed for flexibility, allowing developers to write code that would run on any machine, regardless of the architecture or platform. Java was designed to develop programs which would not require even a computer and develop software that could be embedded in consumer electronic devices. Some of such electronic devices used widely nowadays are like televisions, DVD players, mobile phones, iPods, iPads, cameras, ovens, washing machines, printers, etc. So they all constitute the consumer electronics, which the pioneers of the language had in mind. Now let's see which are the three important Java platforms and what is a Java platform. Well, Java platform is a collection of programs that help to develop and run programs written in Java programming language, just as we have like a railway platform on which the trains run and provide us services. Similarly, Java platform is a collection of programs that help to develop and run programs written in Java. Java platform includes an execution engine, a compiler, and a set of libraries. So every Java platform will have these three things: an execution engine, a compiler, and a set of libraries. There are three main platforms of the Java programming language. Java Platform Standard Edition, known as Java SE, and formerly known as J2SE, is normally used for developing desktop application and forms the core of Java. Java Platform Enterprise Edition, Java EE, formerly known as J2EE, is used for applications which run on servers, for example, websites. Java Platform Micro Edition, Java ME, is used for running Java programming language applications on small devices like mobile phones. Now, who owns Java? We know that Java was developed by Sun Microsystems, but we want to know who is the owner of Java presently. So Sun Microsystems created Java, Oracle acquired Sun Microsystems, and thus they became the owners of Java on January 27, 2010. Java JDK, that is Java Development Kit, and JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine, is open source and you are free to use it. Now, let's come to what is JDK we just talked about. JDK is Java Development Kit. The JDK is a key platform component for building Java applications. At its heart is the Java compiler. The Java Development Kit is one of three core technology packages used in Java programming, along with the JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine, and the JRE, that is Java Runtime Environment. So we need all these three to actually develop and run Java programs. JRE is a software bundle that allows Java program to run. JVM is an environment for executing bytecode. So in the next few slides, we will also see what is bytecode. Now, what is Java Virtual Machine? Java programs are compiled into bytecode. Java programs run in an environment called JVM, that is Java Virtual Machine. JVM interprets bytecode, which is then executed by the Java runtime environment. Bytecode can run on any device because it runs in the JVM. It does not even need a computer to run. So this is what we had said to be the magic of Java, because its code is compiled into bytecode, and it is bytecode that actually makes Java programs architecture and platform independent. Okay, now what is Java? A programming language that can be used to build programs that can run on internet. It provides GUI, graphic user interface, and CUI, character user interface. Two types of programs can be developed in Java. Applets are programs that can run on internet. Applications are programs that run on a standalone computer and can be GUI or CUI based. Features of Java. All living and non-living things are objects in Java. An object dog will have some data like color, size, breed, and it will also have some methods like wag, bark, eat, run, stop. So this is an example of how Java treats things as objects. It could be living as well as non-living. For example, an object bank account will have what data? Account number, name, balance, and of course many more, and methods: deposit, withdraw, show balance, to name a few. So here we have taken an example of a living object and a non-living object. So this is an exercise for you. An object car will have what data? So you can mention what data the object car will have and what methods it will have. So I leave this assignment for you to solve. Now, what are the features of Java? Well, Java is simple. It does not have complex features, some complex features which were present in C and C++ are not there in Java. It is an object-oriented programming language. Why? Because everything is an object in Java. An object has data and methods. So you see, diagrammatically, an object would look like having data and it has certain methods, like we saw in the previous slides. Further, Java is platform independent. We know that Java programs are compiled into bytecode and can run on any operating system. This feature is also called portability. Java is robust. What does that mean? It has strong memory management. It has automatic garbage collection. It is a strongly typed language. The data types have to be declared in the programs. Now, what does that mean? Has strong memory management. That means Java automatically allocates memory when required and it reclaims that memory when not required or when the program gets over. Has automatic garbage collection. So this is the same thing, that it is able to reclaim its memory when it is no longer required. There are different data types to store data, like integer, float, string, and you have to declare those data types at the very beginning. So such a language where you have to declare it in the beginning is called a strongly typed language. Java is secure. It has many layers of security control. It is distributed. Java can be used to create network applications. It is multi-threaded. Programs can be created in Java to perform many tasks simultaneously. Like for example, when we are working in MS Word, we may be typing or we might have given a print command which is sending the concerned page for printing, putting it in a printing queue. We could also be saving the program, but all this does not stop us from continuing our typing process. So, for this reason, different processes are allocated to perform these, and such an application is said to be multi-threaded. So, in Java also, we can create programs which are multi-threaded. Finally, coming to the summary of this presentation, Java has evolved from C and C++. The purpose of Java was to develop a platform-independent programming language. Java's magic is the bytecode, which actually makes it platform-independent. Java programs can be developed, compiled, and executed using JDK, JVM, and JRE in unison. In core Java, we use Java SE, that is the standard edition, and in advanced Java, we use Java EE, that is the enterprise edition. So this was all about this session. I will bring to you some more informative videos in the coming days on Java. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Okay.